As you have seen, trackers can be used for a number of purposes. Adding titles to players, for instance, in this hockey game. Adding titles and graphics to the ice to be able to show logos and that sort of thing, or logos on the boards. But you can also use a tracker to add a privacy component to a video. So in this case here, I have a hockey player, number 31, and I would like to be able to mosaic out the 31 so you can't see it in the video. So the first thing I want to do is select the clip, right-click, and select Track Motion. When the Track Motion dialog opens, you'll notice your tracker list here at the bottom, and also the tracker path. So if I select tracker number 31 and scrub through here, you'll notice there's the tracker path and the tracker following the player. I can go in here and turn the show track path off and just show the point that's getting tracked. Very, very simple. Now, instead of adding an object, I want to go over here and add this mosaic. So now the mosaic, you can change the size of it here. So for instance, in this case here, I want to mosaic out his number. So I'll just drag the mosaic over top of his number. Now if I hit play here, you'll notice the mosaic will follow the player. Once I say OK, then his number has been mosaiced out. If I hit play here, the player's playing away, but he's getting mosaiced out. So this is very useful in times when you have license plates that you don't want to show, for instance, on a highway, or you want to hide somebody's face or hide an object in the scene. You can use it very simply using a tracker with the mosaic feature. Let's add one more title here, just so we can sort of point out the player and also mosaic out his number. So I'll select the clip, right click, select Track Motion. Then on this tracker here, just to confirm that's the one I want to use, say yes, okay. Now I want to add a title, so let me just double click in the title area, and I'll say number 36, and pop that up here. I have left a little bit of transparency on it as well. Then I right click on my title, and I select Match Motion. It will match the motion of the tracker. So in this case here, I have number 31 selected. I can select any other trackers that are present at that moment. And I can scale it as I like and move it. So let me just move it up here. Or actually, we'll put it on the ice. Scale it up a bit. Now I want it to be the same size the whole time. So what I can do is click on the keyframe, right-click on the keyframe, and say copy and paste to all. So all the parameters of this keyframe are the same as the keyframe here. As I mentioned before, you can add keyframes and change the parameters, and they will dynamically scale and distort throughout the keyframe range. So I'll say OK. And now I'll hit play. So simultaneously now I have the tracker following on the ice, and I have the player mosaiced out. So that's mosaicing and tracking with the title.